Hi guys and girls, welcome back to another episode here with a little SQ5. My name is Andre and I want to show you a little trick and a little block I had in my head. So what is the task today? I want to mix front of house. This is what we're going to do as usual. And we have me as the impatient guitar player who has stereo in ears, but wants another compressor on the guitar. He wants another EQ on the kick drum. So me, I want another, let's say, panning for all vocals. And I want a different low cut for, let's say, the snare. This is how I roll. So how are you going to do this with one board and not have an extra board for the monitor duties? This is what I'm going to show you right now. Okay, where to start? The trick is quite simple, actually. So as we have 48 inputs on our SQ series mixers, we can do the following. In my case, I have 16 inputs for the band, and this is my top layer. And as you can see, it's vocals, bass, guitars, tracks, kick, snare, so the drum set on at the end. So what I'm going to do now is I'll take the inputs. In this case, it's the I.O. port because I'm at home and not using my stage box right now. And I'll have them in. I'll let them be the input to another channel, for example, for input channel 33. And this is the layer I am on right now. As you can see, I'm going from that input page. So this is my 1 to 16, and those are the corresponding inputs from the I/O port, or in the live situation, the stage box. And if I go to another layer, these are now the inputs, the channels 33 to 48. And as you can see, I've assigned to them the same input channels. So that means I can have a completely different set of EQs, compressors, and so on. How do you do that? That's simple enough. You take your channel and you just say, well, you are not 33 anymore, you are number one in this case. And you can have that for all the different inputs. You could have 1 to 16 for the mains, you could have 17 to 20, 24 for the first guy in the band, and you can have then the 25 to 32 for the next guy in the band, and 33 to 48 for a third guy. So you could have three different stereo in-ear mixes plus the main mix, and they all can have different EQs and different stuff going on. As you can see, I'm here back on my main layer. Those are the EQs for front of house, and if we go to my in-ears, you can see that different EQs are even have another input stage. This is the tube stage right here, and I don't want to have that for my in-ears. So remember, take the inputs that are going to your normal inputs and just copy them to another channel on the board. So this is quite easy. And now the thing where I had a block in my head, and thanks to Keith and to Stefan from the community, Allen&heath community site, I had no effects at all going to my in-ear bus. And what I did wrong, I had my inputs down. So, and maybe you're asking, eh, if your inputs are down, it's of course you hear nothing. The thing that is important right now to have everything going correctly is the assignment. And this is what we're going to talk about now. So my normal inputs go to the left-right bus as they should go. And my second layer for my in-ears do not go to the left-right bus. They are not assigned to the left-right bus. They are assigned to my mix number one. So And if you see, this is what my in-ear looks like, and this is what my main looks like. And if I have this layer and have a look at my in-ears, none of those channels and none of those EQs sort go to my in-ear. My in-ear is only receiving from my copied layer with different EQs and different processing and so on. The problem I had, I was not getting any hall gated reverb delay and so on in my in-ears. And problem was, I had forgot about pre and post fader stuff. So remember, thanks against Keith and Stefan, those faders need to be up in order to send something to the effects engines, because effects are post faders. You don't want effects to be heard if you pull down your faders. That's why effects are always post faders. So that means if you want to have some effects on your vocals, you have to raise those faders. So on every channel you want to have some effects, and it's no problem, as I said before, because they are not assigned to the left right bus, so they are not messing up your main PA mix. They are only sending stuff to the effects bus. So this is important. This is where I had my block in my head. Take your inputs, copy those input channels to other inputs, to other channels on the board. EQ them differently. Do not assign them to left right. Assign them to your mix bus. Unassign. And if you want to have effects, don't forget to raise your faders, even if nothing is going to left right. They are now signaled to the mix bus. And yes, this is how I do it. If you've got some remarks, some comments, some questions you have about the SQ Series mixer, don't hesitate. Give me a thumbs up and like and comment and all the good things. And maybe I have some money to get a real camera someday, something that focuses if I want to. So enjoy the night and sleep very well. Bye-bye.